In this video, we'll show different options to control the execution of a loop. We'll check the number of completed iterations, execute a loop step by step, and force a loop node to stop its execution based on a predefined condition. One very useful view for controlling loops is the node monitor. The node monitor shows the outputs and configurations of the node that is currently selected in the workflow editor. We can change the view by clicking in the top right corner. If we select another node in the workflow, the view updates dynamically. We can also pin the view to the currently selected node by clicking this pin icon here. Here you can see an example loop that generates 12 timestamps, one for each 15th day of the month in 2020. Here in the node monitor, you can see the number of iterations, which is 12. This is the first iteration, which we can see from this index 0. We want to monitor the progress of the loop when we execute it further, and so we pin the node monitor to this counting loop start node. We execute the entire loop by executing the loop end node. As the loop is running, we can see in the node monitor how the current iteration flow variable increases with each iteration. The yellow loop icon on the loop end node also indicates to us that the loop is currently running. As soon as it turns green, the loop is completely and successfully executed. To reset the whole loop, we can reset any node in the loop. When we do, note that the index of the current iteration is set back to 0. Next, let's check how to control the result of each iteration in the loop on a stepwise basis, something we might need to do for debugging purposes. We can execute the loop step by step by right-clicking the loop end node and selecting Step Loop Execution. This will execute exactly one iteration of the loop. The index of the current iteration is 0 because we've only executed the first iteration. When we select Step Loop Execution again, the loop progresses to the next iteration. To execute all of the remaining iterations, we click Resume Loop Execution. If we wanted to check an intermediate result of the loop while the loop is still running, we can right-click the loop end node and select Pause Execution. Notice, though, that we can only pause the execution at the end of an iteration, and the nodes inside the loop body will always be executed. We could also cancel the loop execution if, for example, we accidentally create an endless loop. Yet another way to control the execution of a loop is to use the Breakpoint node. This node halts the execution of all subsequent nodes in the workflow if its input fulfills a specified condition. We can insert the Breakpoint node at any point inside the loop body. In the configuration dialog of the Breakpoint node, we first check this Breakpoint Enabled option to activate the breakpoint, and then we choose the condition for it. The possible options are an empty table, an active or inactive branch, or a flow variable value. In this case, our loop generates month names in chronological order, and we want to stop it after June, at iteration 6. Therefore, we check the variable matches value option, select the current iteration flow variable here in this menu, and set the value to 6. If we want, we can write a custom error message. For example, the loop stopped because it reached the end of the first half of the year. This error message will be shown when the execution is halted. Now we execute the loop, and it stops at the 7th iteration. We can now read the error message by hovering over the error icon, or by checking the console panel. We can also inspect the results of the previous nodes, which generated the month July, and after that, the loop stopped. If we like, we can disable the breakpoint again, and the loop will execute completely. In this video, we've shown three features that can help us with controlling the execution of a loop. The node monitor panel to help us check the number of completed iterations, the commands available built into the loop end nodes to execute the loop step by step and to pause or cancel the loop execution, and the breakpoint node to stop the loop execution based on a predefined condition.